This is CBSN Boston.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Paula Eben. It's opening day, take two for the Red Sox. After a rainout yesterday, Boston is ready to take the field today. First pitch is a little over an hour away now. Players spent the morning getting reacquainted with Fenway Park. Sports director Steve Burton kicks off our team coverage. He's at the House of Blues.
Yes, this is what opening day should be like, right? Sunny skies in the mid-40s. Instead of yesterday, the Red Sox will kick things off today against the Baltimore Orioles. 2:10 first pitch. Cannot wait for that. And for the first time in what, 18 months? 18 months. There'll be fans in the stands at Fenway Park. Gotta love that. Beautiful day. Just a picture-perfect day for baseball. With a ball game, with the sun shining down on Fenway, the grounds crew never even got a sniff of that waterlogged field yesterday. Well, they were out there this morning making sure that everything is perfect for today's season opener. Fans should be in their seats by 1:30 for the opening ceremony. Starting 10 minutes later, Springfield native Michelle Brooks Thompson will sing the national anthem, which will include a flyover with aircrafts from Massachusetts, New Hampshire, and Vermont. First pitch, Paula, is at 2:10. And let me tell you something. We cannot wait. What a difference a day makes. Perfect day for baseball. Back to you.
Well, CBSN Boston's Dan Roach continues our team coverage. He's on the Green Monster.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. This is the 121st opening day for this Boston Red Sox franchise. Red Sox will be opening up for the 41st time here at Fenway Park, a record of 22-18 in those games. Now, this will also be the third opening day for manager Alex Cora. He, of course, sat out last year due to his suspension, so he's happy to be doing back managing a baseball team and leading them on the way. As for this 2021 opener, Cora, he came into this one excited and ready to go.
I love the game. I love to be around these guys, and, you know, I love this city. I love it. It's not my freaking city, like David said, you know, but there's something about Boston. There's something about Fenway. There's something about being around these people that moves me, you know. It gets me going, and we love it here. We love everything that it comes with the Red Sox, the ups and downs and the obstacles. You know, I'm very excited. I'm actually out of words to explain it, you know. I can't wait for you know, the ceremonies to be over with it and start playing baseball and see where this team is going to take us.
Now, as the Red Sox begin this season, there's plenty of experience for Alex Cora on this team. Of the 29 players on the opening day roster, 13 have played in a World Series, 11 have won a World Series. The manager, he of course won back in 2018 with this Boston Red Sox team. We'll see if they can do it again in 2021. With the Red Sox here at Fenway Park, I'm Dan Roach, CBSN Boston.
Next up is Levin Reed, the MVP of yesterday's rainy morning. He's much drier today and brings us more on opening day from just outside the ballpark.
And this is absolutely a gorgeous day for baseball. 40 degrees in April. This is what you call opening day. And as for the players, when they look up in the stands and see the fans, they are going to be juiced. Xander Bogaerts mentioned that his interaction with the Fenway faithful happens when he steps on the field. And he said that in spring training, it happened all over again.
You know, in the beginning, it was like, hey, you're just yourself, you know, and you got to create that energy. You got to create that adrenaline to get going, you know. But now it's just fans cheering you on and just seeing those seats filling up. Hopefully, as the year goes on, everything gets much better. We get more fans in the stadium, so that'll be much better. But for now, I'm definitely anxious and excited to go out there and see how Fenway Park looks with people back in it, you know?
Now, it's going to be about 12% attendance. That's a little less than 5,000. But when you had zero and now you look up and you have 5,000 or just a little bit less, it's going to be loud and the guys are going to get pumped. Outside Fenway Park, I'm Levin Reed, CBSN Boston.
Well, today is the day Red Sox fans have been waiting for over a year. Thousands of fans are in the stands today. Mike LaCrosse caught up with some of them before they went into the ballpark.
Fans are excited that there is live sports again inside Fenway Park. They showed up bright and early today to prepare.
Happy opening day.
Fans are excited the Red Sox season is about to finally get underway now that the sun is back out.
Here bright and early Thursday morning, standing out in the rain, didn't happen. We're happy that we get to at least be in there and be with other people. I know we have to stay with the guidelines, but it's good to see a baseball game live.
I think it's good. The Red Sox are going to do good today. They have a new lineup. I think it's good. They're going to do good.
Fans are heading back into the park for the first time in a long time. The crowds won't be as big as normal amid the pandemic, but still, people are excited.
I'm excited.
Brian Cohen dressed his doggies Rizzo and Addison for the special day. Cohen lives here in the neighborhood and is pumped fans will bring some energy back to the area.
Last year, this time, I mean, living here, it was a ghost town, complete ghost town. And now you start seeing more people pop up. I mean, Yard Houses, they've been open the whole time, but now they can have people outside. They've been having people outside. You really see the environment starting to change.
Bars and restaurants around the park are also excited. They're hoping this is the beginning of a busy season. Reporting from outside Fenway Park, I'm Mike LaCrosse, CBSN Boston.
Well, some folks south of Boston were left rattled today. People from Hingham to Woods Hole reported feeling a lot of shaking, but the U.S. Geological Survey says it wasn't an earthquake and that it could have been a sonic boom or other atmospheric event. Well, looking at our atmosphere, beautiful shot of Fenway Park. Glad the sun is out, Jacob, for the ballpark fans, but a little cooler than they'd probably like it to be.
Yeah, so we're going to trade the rain for the sunshine, but also chillier temperatures for today. Temperatures struggling to get out of the upper 30s, low 30s as you go inland, so it's going to make for a chilly opening day at Fenway Park. And when you factor in a little bit of that northwest wind, you're seeing those feels like temperatures in the mid to low 20s to near 30 degrees in Boston. So the bottom line is it's feeling more like early March than early April. We will see some improvements as we go into the weekend. There's your mixture of sun and clouds. We'll call it some good sunshine, at least towards the Boston area. A few more clouds mixing in as you go towards the west, and maybe even a couple of snow showers too in parts of the area. I know parts of the Berkshires, northern Tallin County, Connecticut, actually woke up with some light coatings in some spots. But this is going to push on out of here, leaving us with more seasonable conditions into tomorrow. You notice we're only getting into the low 40s for our afternoon highs, waking up with some sunshine for your Saturday, and temperatures rebounding back into the upper 40s to near 50 degrees. I think a lot of us in the upper 40s and tapping that 50 degree mark. But first, we have to get through that frosty morning. By Sunday, middle 50s, if there were to be a shower for the weekend, it would be Sunday morning, and that's going to be mainly outside of 495. Just a sprinkle here or there. Don't cancel those Easter egg hunts by any means, but we could be watching a couple of sprinkles on Sunday. We do have a full check of the 7-day forecast coming up in just a few minutes. Paula?
We'll see you then. Thanks, Jacob. Well, the list of activities that vaccinated Americans can enjoy once again is growing. New CDC guidance says people who are fully vaccinated can travel within the U.S. without getting a COVID-19 test or quarantining. The agency previously had cautioned against unnecessary travel, even for vaccinated people. The CDC says those travelers should still wear a mask and socially distance. As for international travel, health officials recommend vaccinated Americans still get a COVID-19 test before flying back to the U.S. and soon after returning. The CDC says anyone who is not fully vaccinated should hold off on traveling for now. Massachusetts reported nearly 2,500 new COVID cases on Thursday, surpassing 600,000 total cases in the state since the start of the pandemic. Hospitalizations rose to 700 patients, and the 7-day positive test rate fell slightly to 2.49%. And Massachusetts is ramping up vaccinations. Nearly 84,000 people received their shot from Wednesday to Thursday. That's the second highest one-day total so far. And the number of high-risk communities has gone up again. 55 cities and towns are now in the red, up from 32 last week. Catholics are marking Good Friday. As we head into Easter weekend, churches across the state are taking extra precautions. Services are canceled at one parish in Stoneham because of a coronavirus outbreak there. CBSN Boston's Lisa Gresci reports.
It's Good Friday. Here at the Cathedral of the Holy Cross in the South End, services will be both in person and online.
We look forward to welcoming more and more people back to in-person celebration of the Mass and the other sacraments because they're so central to our faith and central to our lives.
The church requiring people to make reservations, this to ensure safe social distancing inside, seating those masked up for Mass one pew apart. But not everyone will celebrate Holy Week services in person. St. Patrick's Church in Stoneham abruptly canceled Mass this week after four office members and a deacon contracted COVID-19.
So what's right for my people is to protect them. And, you know, it hurts us because I wrote all my homilies. I got everything ready for Easter. But again, I want to protect my parishioners and my people.
All services at St. Pat's will now be streamed online. As for Easter Sunday gatherings, the governor is once again urging people to keep them small and host only your immediate families. Reporting in the South End, Lisa Gresci, CBSN, Boston.
There have also been outbreaks at other houses of worship. As of last week, the state reported 11 new and ongoing COVID clusters that resulted in 73 coronavirus cases. But these numbers are significantly lower than the number of clusters linked to the spread of the virus in childcare settings and households. On Monday, vaccine eligibility expands in Massachusetts. Residents 55 and older and those with one medical condition will be able to sign up for a vaccine. In New Hampshire, everyone 16 and older became eligible for a vaccine today. Right now, only the Pfizer vaccine is approved for people as young as 16. So the state is making sure all fixed vaccination sites have the Pfizer vaccine available. Teens must also be with a parent or guardian in order to get their shots. The U.S. economy added nearly a million jobs last month, marking the biggest growth since August. Employers created 916,000 jobs in March, nearly twice as many as in February. The national unemployment rate also dropped slightly to an even 6%. CBSN Boston's your home for streaming news. Coming up in this hour, the cleanup ordered at a Superfund site in Wilmington linked to a childhood cancer cluster. Plus, Johnson & Johnson's plans to test its vaccine on adolescents and this week's to-do list.